hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever.
Okay, I'd like to invite all the children who are here to join me up at the front. So we're going to tell the story. You all know the surprise. The surprise is what? Jesus was raised from the tomb. So I brought with me today, look at these beautiful eggs. Aren't they beautiful? Every color. June and I dyed these yesterday. Yeah, these are beautiful eggs. And I was going to tell you the story of the surprise with the colors of the eggs. So we're going to start with this one. And we have a red. The red kind of matches Jesus. Can you hold up Jesus in his sash? We have red to begin because red reminds us of life, because the blood in our bodies is red. And it reminds us that Jesus is really alive. Next, we have light blue, because it was really early in the morning, and the sun hadn't come up, and the sky was kind of this color. You dyed these yesterday at my house. This one, what color would you say that is? Kind of a tan white. We actually didn't dye this one at all. This one is a brown egg, and it's this color because we remember that there were claws wrapped around Jesus, but Jesus wasn't in the claws anymore, so they were laying on the ground. So this is for the claws that were laying on the ground because his body wasn't there. Yeah. And then, what came up over the horizon? The sun. And it made the skies what color? Yeah. And that made all of the green things that were coming up glow and be bright green. And Jesus was alive, and later that day, he broke bread with his friends, and that's a story you'll hear next week. And then the last color, and then the rest of these are just extras, is purple, because Jesus is actually a king, and purple is the color of kings. We believe Jesus came back to life, he rose from the dead, and he became king. So the reason we have eggs to tell a story of Jesus is because the egg kind of reminds us of a tomb, a place where bodies are laid when they die, because there's no windows, there's no doors, there's no way out. It's closed up. And in the Eastern Orthodox Church, which is a part of the Christian church in another part of the world, they have a tradition of taking an egg and breaking it on Easter, because the tomb was cracked open and Jesus was not here's the funny thing about their tradition. They break the eggs on their heads. And we're all going to do it. So here's what, you don't have to. Here's the thing. We're going to practice it. I'm going to do one, two, three, and you're going to break the egg on your head. You're going to use this side of it. And when I say one, two, three, we're going to say, Christ is risen, and then we're going to break the egg. And after everyone out there hears the crack, they're going to say, He is risen indeed. So let's just practice the talk here. Let's just practice. Let's pretend like we have an egg here. Christ is risen. Oh, I'm sorry. Wait. Start over. One, two, three. Christ is risen. Then we break the eggs.
Christ is risen indeed.
Okay, one more time, just so I get it. One, two, three. Christ is risen. Crack. He is risen indeed. Okay, who wants an egg? We are going to do this. Remember your practice? Yes. There's no yolk coming out. Yes. You just took a bath. I completely understand. I will not do that to you. Okay. Are we ready? One, two, three. Christ is risen. Showing that you are the King. We love you very much, Jesus.